Look, it's like the Red Sea. Wow. Go through, children of God, to the promised land.
Hi, I'm Danielle. I do too much. I like hair, talking, cosplay, music, art, and stuff.
Hello. Hi, and welcome to Star Puppy. I'm Danielle, your resident weirdo. Welcome to the weirdness. Today is a day of education. I just wanted to do a video in the same vein as this video, why you should love your 4C natural hair, something like that, I don't know what I said, and talk about something that's not really often talked about in social media in general, and not particularly at all. And that would be thin, fine, natural hair. I'm also going to be taking down what I hope is a braid out. We will see. But even if it's not, I'ma still love my fine, thin, natural 4C hair. An intro to Fluff Nugget. Fluff Nugget is my head of hair. Fluff Nugget is short to medium length, fine strands, which mean that the strands themselves are very skinny, 4C everywhere, very consistent in that regard, and I'm appreciative. Medium porosity, which means that water goes into my hair not fast, not slow speed, and it leaves my hair not too fast, not too slow, which is pretty great for me. And the topic of today, Fluff Nugget has sparse density. Now, when people say you have thin hair, what they're actually saying is you have sparse density, which means the number of hairs on my head is lower than average. That's what I'm talking about. Some people call that fine hair, which is not correct, and thin hair, which is more correct, but sparse density, like, how do you not understand that? So that's what we're going with. But you better believe that the title of this video gonna have some kind of thin, sparse, fine, something in it. So this is the braid out with Wetline Extreme Gel that I tried in my last episode of Star Puppy versus Shrinkage. And if you haven't seen that, please click here. As you can see, look at that. Look at that part. You can see my whole scalp. It's not even tight. Like, a couple months ago, it was the first time someone really noticed that I don't have thick hair. I just don't. I have sparse density hair. And I was doing my hair for some kind of Star Puppy versus something. And, you know, you can see, like, my whole scalp. Like, look at that. It's my scalp. Hey, friend. You being good to my strands this day?
Good, you better.
But someone asked me if I had a bald patch, and I was like, huh? And then they put the timestamp, and I was like, oh, no, that's just my scalp. I can see it at all times. It's fine. And first of all, no, I do not have traction alopecia. No, I do not have any form of alopecia. No, I don't have any medical issues that contribute to hair loss. No. Some people, like me, just don't have a lot of hair. And it feels really weird to say that, and it probably feels weird to hear that in, like, a very honest and candid way. Let's discuss, shall we? Gonna put some of this sweet almond oil on my hands to decrease. Frizz! Let's see. First and foremost, I'ma just say it. Sparse density hair, thin hair. We will say thin hair from now on because you know what I'm talking about. Thin hair gets, like, no love. When it comes to representation, like online, Instagram, commercials, because as y'all know, or maybe you don't know, whatever, you about to know now, I am an actor and model in Atlanta, Georgia, and there's a ton of natural hair stuff that happens here. When it comes to glorification, seeing like models and commercials for hair care. And I'm talking the natural brands. We're not talking Aussie Moist. We're talking, well, I'm not going to say anything because I want to work with all those companies. But you know who I'm talking about. Pretty much everybody. You'd be hard pressed to find someone with sparse density, someone with thin hair. And you might catch someone with short hair. Don't get that confused. They still probably have pretty decently thick hair. But it's not often that you're gonna see anyone's scalp in a commercial. But the reality of it is, not everyone in the natural hair community, people who have cut off their hair and are part of this community and this movement, not all of us have thick hair. In fact, I might reason to believe that a good chunk of people actually don't have thick hair, but they don't really post about it since there's really not a lot of role models or idols or people that we're aspiring to look like online. So that sucks. I'm very proud to be a YouTuber who has sparse density hair, because like, do y'all know anybody without a ton of hair on their head in this YouTube space? Because generally, and like, no shade or anything, but typically natural hair bloggers and vloggers, especially when it comes to like the kinkier, tighter textures, you gonna see the people with like two or three people's worth of hair on their heads. And it's, don't get me wrong, it's absolutely stunning. I am not here to say that that is not beautiful, because I'm subscribed to them too. So I don't get to say nothing. Nothing. We can't all be Nap 85. There, I said it. Or the urban bush babies with like just a sickening amount, just a sickening mane, honey. Like, jeez Louise, it's incredible. It's incredible. But like, who do you know in the spotlight with a following like that without like just a ton of hair? Just a ton. And I understand it's kind of what we're all going for. There has to be something, there has to be an ideal, you know? And the ideal very much so has been determined in our community to not be sparse density hair. I do not make the rules. I do not even like the rules. But I know the rules. So, there's that. So I'm doing my best to be on here and test things and show that not having a bunch of hair is okay. And pretty cute sometimes. We'll see about this braid out though. Another drawback is that some styles just ain't gonna work for thin hair. It's just not gonna happen. Someone in my real life like suggested, like we were pressed for time, and she suggested like, hey, why don't you just like wear some Bantu knots? I was like, outside? That does not leave this household, young lady. Oh no. Oh no no. Have you ever seen mini twists on thin hair? It's just, it, when I was in corporate America, yeah, I was in corporate America once. Plot twist. I wore mini twists to work one day, and fortunately, I was the only black person who worked at this establishment, so no one knew how bad it looked, but it looked bad. Not to say, if you have sparse density hair, you can't make some mini twists work for you. Danielle cannot make them work for Danielle. As for me and my house, as far as what I want to present to the world, and that is not necessarily my entire scalp. You can see like my whole head, my guys. Like, weirdos, like, you can see my head. There it is. Like, there's no, look, it's like the Red Sea. Wow. Go through, children of God, to the promised land. I'm not a fan of that. And that's my own opinion about my own head of hair. So no one can tell me nothing. Y'all can't tell me nothing. Which brings me to another point, another drawback. It's just a reality. I, in my personal hair journey, find that I have to style my hair more often than my thicker-haired friends. Because when you just have a bunch of hair, it looks a little more together just because it's like an art. A single shape can look a little abstract by itself, but adding repetition and density and multiplying one pattern makes it look intentional as a finished piece. Case in point, patterns. So when you don't have the density to kind of just wear whatever, you don't really have the choice to just wear your hair messy. I can't wear my hair messy. There's not enough of it to convince people it was a choice or a style. That's what I'm getting at. And again, I'm talking about my personal experience. If you want to go and do whatever you want, that's fine. You're probably grown. If not, then consult an adult. But for me and my house, we will have a braid out. Another thing that's just kind of a drawback and kind of it's been a challenge for me is that you can see through my hair. That's irritating. I don't like that you can see through my hair, but that has always been the case. In terms of filming, it looks a little bit thicker than it actually is. And as far as photography, it looks easily 50 to 70% denser than it actually is, which is very helpful for my line of work. It's sparse density, it's thin hair, but you can't document it. Also, lighting can play a huge role in how I feel about my hair. If I'm kind of down in the dumps about it not being thick and never going to be thick unless I take probably like surgical action. For instance, I have a full-length mirror right there, and I have a giant window right here and right there. So I am always backlit when I'm checking out my full look, which is terrible because it looks like I have roughly, I'd say like 3 strands of hair on my head. That's just a rough estimate, you know, just some guesswork. It's just the rough numbers. I can do a little more by the end of the week. But, and this one is a little more personal. I think all of these can be very classified as Danielle just ranting about her head of hair, and if you find that you agree, then that's cool. But this, I feel like, is maybe just a me thing. I really, really like hair. I've always loved hair, and I've always drawn hair. I've painted hair. I think it's so beautiful in all of its forms across race, age, gender, whatever, style. I love hair. For me, it really symbolizes and is, it's very integral in my sense of closeness with someone. Hair is such an intimate thing. It's not quite part of your body, but it's like the extension of your mind and your brain. It's getting a little artsy-fartsy. I'm hearing it too. Don't worry. I'm bringing it back. But I think it's such an intimate and close-knit thing to touch someone's hair. And when it comes to romantic relationships, absolutely, I am all up in your mane. So yeah, I like hair. And to me, I can never return that favor. I don't let people touch my hair, even when we are together. Like, don't touch my hair. Because it's so brittle. Not only do I not have a ton of it, and I don't have a lot of strands to like spare if you're not gentle with it or very well versed in touching black hair, like it's just I also have those fine strands we were talking about. So my hair, in particular, has one hit point. It can take one hit and then it's gone. So I can't reciprocate that thing that I love so much to do in all of my personal relationships. So like, that sucks. This is like a nitpicky one, and I know that this exists in like all array, like the entire scope of how many hairs you can have on your head in terms of density, but like I feel personally when either, oh, perfect example. I am at my most vulnerable right before I pick out my hair or right after I've installed a style and haven't put on my scarf yet. Like, even like my friends, like my long-term friends, you are gonna be hard-pressed to see me in between the installation phase and the scarf application phase. I do not want people to see my thin hair and all my scalp out blowing in the wind. Meanwhile, I put it on the internet all the time. And I'm about to be at that stage very shortly. Hi, I'm Danny Five Strands. Now, plot twist. Those were a whole bunch of the drawbacks and the challenges, the realities of having not thick hair. But you know what? There's actually a bunch of pros. First and foremost, I'm recording this, and I still took all of those braids down and about to fluff out and be done in less than 20 minutes. And also, it goes the same way for my nighttime routine. Like, I can style my hair in like 15 minutes, and that's not even me rushing. Also, my hair doesn't tangle as much. I'm not sure if this is Fluff Nuggets thing, or if other people with kind of fine, sparse density hair also find that like your hair doesn't get mad. I mean, there's only 5 hairs, what's there to fight about? I'm not sure if this is a fine, like, strand thing, but my hair is also incredibly soft. Like, it's pretty much soft all the time, unless I tried it extra hard. Also, once you learn how to work with your hair, you could fake thickness. This is your best friend in that endeavor, by the way. Also, again, styling, while it can't achieve every style, because it just can't, not in the way that I want it to look like, it can still do a bunch of cute stuff. Like, once you learn how to work with your hair, you can really pull off some really cute styles. And as a bonus round, because we don't do our hair for men now, do we? But men don't know the difference. In my opinion and my experience, women are typically the ones who can tell if you have thick or thin hair. I think, for the most part, and in my opinion and in my experience, men don't care. Because they're just like, yeah, that. So if that's kind of like an intimidation factor, like you think you can't pull them because you have 5 strands of hair like me, now you could pull them. Trust me, you can. Also, those cute styles, you can do it like half the time. It's like a cheat code. It's like a secret path in a like a racing game. You just go through the waterfall and then you're at your Bantu knot out in half the time. Yay! And last, but certainly not least, I would definitely argue that this is the most important takeaway from the plot twist pros of having fine, thin, sparse density, whatever you want to call it, hair. Like, I'm just happy I have hair. Do you know how many people don't have hair and want to? I'm grateful for all 5 of you. Ain't that right, Huey, Dewey, Louie, Chewy, and Bantooey? Look at that. I done doubled my strands from 5 to 10. Look at God. I'm so grateful for each and every one of my strands, in all seriousness, because there was a time in my life where I did have bald patches. This is not thick hair, but you know what? It's mine, which makes me love it. That's it. Like and subscribe, I upload on Saturdays. I want to know what a struggle of your hair is, no matter what kind it is, and what you're thankful for about it. Because it's really important to recognize realities, but still be grateful. So I would like you to subscribe so you can join the weirdness. Hit that bell for notifications so you can always be early to the weirdness. Like this video to appreciate the weirdness. And follow me on Instagram to see all the weirdness in between. Like this one time I casually met Le Twins. Están celosos? Sí, claro que sí. I don't speak French, so I spoke Spanish. It's the closest thing I got. It's a romantic language. So this has been me, Danielle, your resident weirdo, Star Puppy, signing off. Say it with me now. Star Puppy, away!
Don't forget to like, share, subscribe if you enjoyed the video.